Form 2, mm-hmm. I tried
common
entrance, and I passed as a Semonikes Ashanti Region.
Mampom.
But my daddy felt, my daddy had come back.
Okay, he had returned from Nigeria
yes,
to Ghana.
Yes, Ghana. Oh, okay. He was working with UAC, GBO Levant.
Okay.
He said, I had become too fancy. Mm-hmm. So he wanted me to get some other exposure.
Okay.
So I attended first. At that time, my brothers were attending Zion College mm-hmm. in Amoda. Mm-hmm. So I was very young then. So, and then it was like, because I didn't go through, you know, I was supposed to go to Mampon and I wasn't going mm-hmm. there. So he said, because I was young, I should join my brothers in Zion College.
Okay.
But I joined them for a year, and because I was...
That is now Volta Region.
Yeah, all this is all in Volta Region.
Okay. That's Zion College?
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I don't remember the year.
Let me see. That was also maybe in the late... '60s.
Okay.
I was in the same class with Kenji Asa.
And the former...
Former's deputy school.
Oh, so he was your classmate?
Yes.
Then. Oh, okay. Then, okay. Oh, I see.
Left.
Okay.
So then I said I preferred Keta Secondary School.
Keta.
I started Form 2.
Form 2 from Keta.
Keta Secondary School.
What were you doing basically in England?
Okay, I did my A-levels in England. I did it in a year. And then I was a science student actually.
Okay.
So I did my biology, chemistry, and physics. Then I moved. Then actually the aim was to become a medical doctor. But I ended up doing biochemistry. And then after the biochemistry, I realized that I wasn't like satisfied. So I branched into health and beauty therapy.
See, health and beauty therapy. Did you have any education?
Yes, I did. Barry International.
Where?
D-U.
D-U.
Then Barry, B-A-R-R.
B-A-R-R-Y.
International.
Okay. That was also in England. Where is that in England?
The Barry is in London.
Oh, okay. Okay, all right. So how long was the course?
Because I already had like a science background,
so yeah.
So it was easier for me. So I took the highest of it. So it was more on therapy, the beauty therapy, and then the health aspects. So it took about a year and a half.
Yeah.
And the arrangement didn't work because she wasn't a fully qualified person, and then the contribution wasn't well. You know, in terms of partnership, so she left it for me because it was more of my equipment and everything. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So I ran it for 4 years. And then I relocated to Ghana in 19. I came back and started second image.
So the second image came to being in 86.
86.
How did it go when you wanted to set up second image? How did it?
Oh,
you came to Ghana.
Yeah.
How was that?
You know, in 86, what I had in mind didn't exist in the system, so I had to start from somewhere. When I came, you know, it was like facials, mostly people were into hair, and then that was the nearest to my course, the hair part. But then my interest was more on the beauty. So I thought I could duplicate what I had in England, like a small beauty clinic. government advised me that in Ghana they needed more of the exercise bed and all that. So that was included. So I realized that the aerobic side became popular. It's because there wasn't anything apart from going to a like fit or something. So I started with the aerobic classes. We used to run all this from my living room.
Okay. So you must start from your current location?
No.
You start from where?
From my living room.
Oh,
Asalam down.
Okay.
Yes. So it's like in the morning, after the kids have gone to school, then I push my chairs back and everything. Then my living room becomes my clinic and my other small room at the back, clinic, and then the aerobic classes too is there.
Oh, okay. So when did you acquire the aerobic classes?
I went, even the school started in Asalenda.
Oh, okay, before you moved
yes.
to Asalenda.
Yes, I used my living room and my boys' quarters.
Okay.
To start the school. You know, initially we were doing like training, but not so formal. But then, later we realized that there was nothing like that apart from the regular apprenticeship and all that that people were doing. And even not in the beauty, only the hair. So we decided to set up a formal school. So we advertised and then we got people in. My first group of students were 6, and then also in my living room. And then as more students came, we moved to my boys' quarters. Even my hostel started in that same building.
Oh, okay. That's Asalam down.
Yeah.
So, would you say since you started second image, it has been successful despite the challenges?
Initially people thought I was like joking. You see, because you know in Ghana people want to come to a place where it's like big, and then this lady was like operating from her living room, and few people will come, and people didn't even take me serious.
Okay.
But then that was my serious business.
Okay.
But I, as I did that, I did other things. I actually started, I realized that the education was not there on what I was doing, on the diet aspect and all that. So I decided to start a magazine. So I started a second image magazine. And then I had like high hopes, so I did like a glossy type of magazine where even the covers of the magazine were brought from UK. And I said, the magazine, I would say it should have been successful, but then some vendors, in Ghana those days, we relied on, initially it was like an agent. Somebody who was into distributing magazines, he came to me, they would give it to me, for some percentage.
Mm-hmm.
I gave it to him, and then, could you imagine, after a couple of months, I went there, and they were all in his room, in his office. So I had to look for another way of marketing it. So I had to use like a newspaper vendors, vendors to distribute. It was difficult. It was very rough where you put in all your monies. It's not as if you are going to the bank for money, your personal monies into these things. And it wasn't, but then somehow it became, people started, I had a diet. I normally would have every month, it's a diet plan for the month, and people took with exercises. And then some advice for youth and everything. So that also took off eventually. I ended up printing in Nigeria and everything. But then I got I became, like, I remember my little Apple computer where I was doing, those days we called it Macintosh. And I was doing my paging in and everything for my little room and all that. So I was doing my paging and everything, yes. And then I took a job. Even some very big companies like Nestle and Toyota and all those things. I got them, convinced them to put their adverts in it. And I'll go, because there was no, you know, we didn't have a color separation. So I'll take their artwork, take it to Nigeria, put it together for them, and put it in the market. The trend, but Ghanaians are not leaders. So eventually, I had Audrey Gadigwe and myself, we came together, we co-published our African Women's Option.
Ah, Professor Gadigwe.
Yeah.
After the second image magazine, we came to do our own magazine.
Yeah, we did our own.
Yeah, with Audrey. And that one could also not
so you know, Ghanaians are not readers. Ghanaians are not readers. Yeah. Because you see, it was quality reading. But then, as we were doing the AU, I was like, those days, you know, tabloids. But no, man, we had just very few newspapers. So I became the managing editor of People and Places.
Oh, that's a PMP.
And surprisingly, that succeeded because it was mostly trash. You know, when I say trash, it's like talking about things, unusual things, and they were not lies. You see, most people thought their stories were. But then sometimes I actually go around, I investigate what they bring. So we started with even most of these very popular radio people. Now, some of them work with me, you see, including Sefa, Kaili, and you know, this guy, a lot of them.
So PMP also, all this while you were still running your
yes, PTS, you know, because it was like a timely thing.
Okay.
I was concentrating more on the aerobics.
Okay. So you got it in the PMP for how long?
Oh, I was there for on all the big times. I remember there was a week that we printed over 200 and something thousand copies.
Yes,
it was a daily deal.
Yeah.
Some of the very big stories I was writing. But then I was like, you know, out.
You were also writing for the Mirror?
Yes, for Mirror.
What is the title of Mirror?
The Mirror.
The Weekend Mirror. What was your column?
It was a beauty. It was like, I paid for the page.
So you bought for the page?
I bought the
page and
the
you
page
always
and
then
I always,
for
yes,
page.
Yes.
Oh, I see. What's the population? What's your school population? The second age.
Okay, we have three branches.
Nah, where I know of Tema in Accra.
I don't have Tema.
Oh, I thought it was one Tema. So where are the branches?
I have it Accra, Kumasi.
Accra,
Kumasi, and Dini.
Dini.
Yes,
so
I have.
You mean the Volta?
Yeah, Volta, Ashanti, and then Accra.
Okay. So what is the total population of the school?
Level, the highest level.
Okay. winter you are few still with, not few still, still with some the media, you decided to focus on?
Well, I was even the Brimpad. I was the general secretary.
Okay, for this Brimpad, general secretary.
Well, that time, principal was the president.
No, can you remember the year?
Do I? Sometimes. In fact, we were the first, we started it. The publishers came together. And we started it, and I think the business vice was at the top. From Lajapon.
Lajapon for MDB's at the top.
Yes. Decided that okay, you should people because they would come and help. Because all the time I was doing my buja buja, they were with me before they left.
Yes.
Mm. So when I said, so the older one came in 2003. Just then I moved to the bigger premises. So I started, had a hostel, then I added the fashion to it, and then the school started growing. Then 5 years later, the younger one came to join. Yes. So actually, they are the directors of the company. So the future, I have a younger generation behind me. So the sky is the limit. We are even changing the name. This, it's in process, to a skills college. So second image, in the hands of the boys. People think that we say women's, but then the boys are handling it fine. Yes. They've added like modern ideas with this social media and all kinds of things to it. So it makes it more interesting. And then the students belong because they don't think it's, I try as much as possible myself to belong to the youth because I have a lot of young women. My population is like